Hey everybody, I'm Geno Reynolds from The Real Opinion. Today on The Real Opinion, we're going to be talking about two movies. One is about the Scouts versus the Zombies. Another is the biopic of Chef Gordon Ramsay. Wait, it's not about Chef Gordon Ramsay? Could have fooled me. Here are two films about leaving the job to the professionals.
First up is Scout's Guide to the Zombie Apocalypse. Be prepared. I learned that motto as a former Cub Scout. This movie is all about just that. Be prepared. In this story, when the zombies come, like they always do, three unlikely heroes step up to fight back and save their town. While not as intelligent of a zombity or zomcom or whatever these things are called now as Shaun of the Dead or Zombieland, I still found it to be kind of fun and entertaining. Now, I'm not saying that this is a good movie, but I would put it on par with a movie like Cooties. At least it's not The Walking Deceased. While I thought the action and most of the jokes were entertaining, I did feel a lot of the raunchier jokes fell flat. Other things worked really well. I've got two words for you, zombie cats.
Huggy,
I like that the story didn't try to focus on the cure or anything like that. The premise is simple and the character is a bit cliche, but this is still a goofy, gory, and somewhat fun film just to sit back and enjoy the stupidity. Next up is Burnt. Bradley Cooper stars as a former superstar chef that had it all and lost it. Think of him as a down-and-out Chef Gordon Ramsay, especially since Cooper partially based his character on the famous chef. While this movie had some things to like, such as its wide array of characters and a decent twist going into the third act, I felt that too many of the cliched themes and the abrasiveness of Cooper's character really hurt this film a lot. A lot of this movie felt like a really long episode of Hell's Kitchen. Cooper spends a lot of his time yelling at his underlings. This makes him an interesting character, but he is extremely unlikable for most of the story. This makes his change later in the film feel a bit unearned. Also, a love story feels really forced between Cooper and Sienna Miller's characters. Why do these characters have to fall in love in movies? I think if they would have just become really good friends, it would have worked a lot better. Then there is a former girlfriend side plot and the past catching up to our main character side plot as well. These made the story way more complicated than it needed to be. While this isn't a totally terrible movie, I would recommend something like Jon Favreau's Chef instead.
But remember, it's only just one guy's opinion. Tune in on Friday to The Real Opinion, where I'll be taking a look at two new films, Sandra Bullock's Our Brand is Crisis, and Robert Redford and Kate Blanchett's Truth. Until next time, I'm Geno Reynolds from The Real Opinion.